My name's William Paiva, and I am an alcoholic, and hopefully you guys are too, because you'll enjoy this a lot more if you guys are drunk. If you get through Scott's Phillips Startup Weekend, you'll go through a process to try to raise venture capital. I'm going to tell you all the lies. The first one you'll hear is find a lead venture capital fund and we'll invest. Venture capitalists are lemmings. Even though they'll tell you they're entrepreneur, they're all lemmings. Nobody wants to be first. Nobody wants to be left out. Get one of these guys to lead your deal and everybody else will fund your opportunity. So find a lead investor and all the venture firms will invest. The second lie you'll hear is none of our companies compete with you. This is their way of trying to find out more about what you're doing and about what other people are doing in the industry. It's one of the classic, it's the simplest way to learn as much as you can about an industry. Invite them in to make a pitch, and then they end up funding your company, and this is what it ends up looking like on their calendar. They go to the Facebook board meeting in the morning, and they go to MySpace board meeting in the afternoon. So don't get caught up that venture capitalists won't invest in companies that compete with one another, so be careful of it. They'll also tell you if you come to them and you meet them at a cocktail party like this, and if you come to me and I'll tell you this, you'll know it's a lie. If you say you got a business plan, I'll tell you to go to my website. There's a button on there to submit the business plan here. I will tell you all of those emails go directly to my secretary. She reviews all of them. Her current track record is zero approved deals and 632 deals that she's killed because they all end up in the paper shredder. Point being, don't go through the website. Come directly to the venture guys to get the deal funded. The other thing we'll tell you is we're all hands-on investors that will be actively involved in your deals, that we will be helping you shape and mold and grow your business. And we will be there with you thick and thin through everything. And that is true to a certain extent. But there are other things we do that as hands-on investors. We'll call them networking events, but we do a lot of things that are hands-on during the investment process as well. The other thing we'll tell you is we've got lots of experience building your business. And you should definitely try to find venture guys who do have lots of experience building your business because you want their help, you want their assistance, you want to learn from their war stories, etc. But often they're misleading you because sometimes as soon as they get done meeting you, they're going to go to Google and type in what is VoIP or VoIP because they don't know really what it is. So they're going to learn from Google. So really make sure that they truly understand and have the knowledge that you hope they have. The other thing they'll tell you is all of our partners have built successful businesses. Therefore, you can rely on our knowledge. You can rely on everything we've told you on how to build a successful business because we've been there, done that. Be very careful of that and ask them what kind of businesses they've built in the past because you want to make sure it's relevant to whatever business that you're operating because it isn't always relevant. So make sure that all of them really have had successful businesses that they've built that's relevant to your industry, the key being relevant to your industry. Don't go to a telecom guy to invest in healthcare and vice versa. Without the founder, there is no company. This is one of the classic things that I give advice to founders. You're always very scared of building the best team around your company. My message in this particular slide is don't assume that you're indispensable because you are often very dispensable, that no company is greater than its founder. Make sure that you build the best team you have around them because otherwise you'll get an email like this the second day after you get funded that we're going to let the founder go. So really make sure that you build the best team around you. The next piece of advice I have for you is it's not about me, it's not me, it's the rest of the investor syndicate. These are the venture guys who don't want to tell you the truth and they're going to blame it on the rest of the board of the company. And this is all about control. You really have to make sure that you're willing to cede control to your board because they're going to end up controlling a lot of what you're doing and make sure that you really trust them and that they give you proper advice because there's going to be somebody who's going to draw the short straw and come communicate the bad message to you. The other lie you'll hear from venture capitalists, especially the coastal ones, is we invest all over the country. And this is an issue around geography, and it's true of every state other than two in the country, California and Massachusetts. The other 48 states have this issue. This may be true that they invest all over the country, but this is what you often find out immediately after they make the investment, is that they'll want to move the company to a particular geography, either because it's closer to the venture firm or because it's more relevant for the particular industry that you're involved with. So be willing to accept a geographic change. The other is valuation. Everybody's always worried about dilution and how much they're going to have to give up the company. We have very sophisticated methodologies for determining valuation. They're tried and true and they've been used for decades. And people often ask what they are, and it's really the bingo machine sitting in the back room. And if you happen to draw a B ball, then it's going to be a very low valuation. If I happen to draw an O ball, it'll be a really high valuation. That's just a joke. The point being, don't get hung up on dilution. The reality is it's all about making money. We won't make money. If you don't make money, it sounds like a billboard, but that is the truth. Thank you.